I didn't think anything could top last night for OU when the softball team won 8-0 run rule style, bottom of the fifth, by hit by pitch. Little Homer at the bat style, old school Simpsons. Hey, we win! Someone check on Homer. But while you were sleeping, OU got a commit from a quarterback nonetheless for the year 2025. Yes, you heard me right, 2025. OU has yet to get a commit from anybody for 2024 yet, but here we are getting commits for 2025. Kevin Sperry is the kid out of Rock Hill, Texas, and just took part in an Under Armour camp. We'll be taking a visit to Oklahoma in about 8 to 9 days or so, and a lot of people have questions about this, and I've heard everything from Gunslinger, comparisons to Baker, comparisons to Chase Daniel. Not that part, the football part. But it's just asking if it's a good or bad thing. Well, number one, we'll be getting commits for 24 soon. I think early April, hint, hint, if you know what I mean. You've been following that recruitment. So we'll probably be getting another quarterback soon, just not in the order you thought we'd be getting one. But considering how this guy's taken visits in March and, you know, this sets the foundation for 2025. I mean, first of all, having a quarterback in your class, period, is very important, because whether you like it or not, your quarterback is going to be the magnet that draws in people, like, regardless of, like, how talented, you know, having the quarterback, if you have that set, regardless of what year, what class, that's important. That's a guy who can rally around the troops and help you build a class. Like, look at Jackson Arnold. Overall, I'm sure the average person out there who follows recruiting hasn't even spent too much time on 2025, unless you're an insane person like me or some other people I know in a Discord server. But because right now the focus is on 2024, we're trying to get Williams and Winari and David Stone and guys like the Peyton Pierce, guys like that. You're trying to get the ball rolling with some really heavy hitters on defense. And for 2025, for me personally, I haven't really, peeked into that too much, because it's just, we're so far away. And I know that's another question people are going to have. It's like, well, he's committed now, and we know how Brent Venables deals with commitments. If you're committed, you're done. You're not taking visits anywhere else, or at least official visits anyway. So how is this commit going to stick? It's like, well, number one, it's not like it's a 12-year-old kid like Lane Kiffin style at USC back in the day. But I will say this, from what I understand, this offer to this kid was really, really special. So, hint, hint, dream school. So, if you get an offer from your dream school, and everyone around you is on board with it, and as long as everything stays in place at the program, you know, granted, it's a long time, a lot can happen in like a little less than 2 years, but still, in about 18 months, he will be able to actually sign paperwork that says he wants to go to Oklahoma. But yes, this sounds like a kid who's like grew up in Texas, watched OU football, and this is the guy, this is the school he wanted to go to. He don't need to take a trip to LSU or Alabama or Georgia or SC or whatever. He don't need to do those trips. He says, I want to go to Oklahoma. As long as Oklahoma's good, he's going to do that. So I think we're in a good spot right there. So again, 18, 19 months from now, who knows? We'll see what happens. But just look at a little bit of his tape. I think not a whole lot to go off right now, because he still has junior and senior film to put on tape. So if you go to certain websites, you know, he doesn't have his ranking yet, but I think he's considered a 4-star at the moment. So I don't know how that works, but so if you look at his profile right now, it's like there's no official ranking from at least Rivals or 24/7. I haven't looked elsewhere at the moment, but somewhere out there has him as a 4-star. So, but he's pretty talented. Got the whole gunslinger mentality thing going for him. But other than that, it's hey, it doesn't hurt to get a head start on 2025. So, still working on 2024. That has to be a first though for Oklahoma, or for I don't know first anyway. Where you have a commit for the class ahead of the current one that you're working on for the year. So, oh, it's just good, more good times in Norman, Oklahoma. So, with that being said, I was expecting some commitments at some point, not like this, but hey, I'll take them. There's nothing wrong with getting a head start on the next class. So tonight we got OU Florida State in softball. We'll keep an eye on that one, see how that one turns out. Should be a fun one. But until then, until any more fun recruiting news pops up, I'll catch y'all later. Boomer Sooner.